Have you ever noticed how the world around you changes throughout the year? One day, flowers are blooming, then later in the year, leaves are falling, and then you can see snow and ice. It's like the Earth has its own magical cycle. What's going on? That's what this video is all about. We're going to learn the four seasons of the year. Spring, summer, fall, and winter. Every season has its own special qualities, making each one unique. The seasons happen because the Earth is always moving around the sun. That's why we have seasons. And we're going to learn about all four of them, which is good. I mean, it would be weird if we just learned about two or three of them, and winter was like, "Hey, excuse me, I'm here. Come on." All right, what season should we start with? I was kind of thinking spring. You know what? Let's go for it. Spring. Wow, that's perfect spring music right there. Spring usually begins around March 20th or 21st and lasts until June 20th or 21st. Notice that means it's still technically spring when most of you start your summer vacation. That's pretty interesting. And honestly, that's something even a lot of adults don't know. Spring usually begins around March 20th or 21st and lasts until June 20th or 21st. It's the time of year between the cold of winter and the heat of summer. At the start of spring, the weather is cool, but as the days pass, it gets warmer and warmer, and by the end of spring, it can just feel like summer, you know? So that's when spring happens. But what is it actually like? Well, spring is a season when everything comes to life. Just look at this tree in winter. Its branches are bare, all of the leaves are gone. It's like the tree is asleep, you know? Wake up, tree! But in spring, fresh green leaves cover the branches again. It's like the trees wake up from their winter nap, growing new leaves and soaking in the sunshine and warmer weather. We also see flowers begin to bloom all around us. You can see butterflies fluttering from flower to flower, and bees buzzing around, collecting pollen. These little creatures are busy helping the flowers grow and spread by carrying pollen. That's pretty cool. Spring is also a time when many baby animals are born, okay? Really cute baby animals! With the weather warming up and plenty of food around, it's the perfect season for new life to begin. Another thing we see a lot of in spring is rain. That's right, rain. These showers bring much-needed water to flowers, trees, and grass, helping them grow strong and healthy. Have you ever heard the saying, April showers bring May flowers? Well, it's true. The rain we see, not just in April, but throughout spring, helps all the new plant growth this season is famous for. Spring, a season of excitement and change. Just look at this butterfly enjoying spring. It's great. The weather continues getting warmer and warmer as spring goes on, until finally we reach summer, a time of adventure and sunshine. Summer picks up right where spring left off. Summer usually begins around June 20th or 21st, and lasts until around September 22nd or 23rd. That means summer starts when most of you are already out of school, enjoying sunny days and fun activities. It also means the summer season is still going when most of you are back in school for a new school year. Summer usually begins around June 20th or 21st and lasts until around September 22nd or 23rd. One of the things summer is most famous for is the heat. Summer is the hottest season of the year. The sun shines high in the sky, warming up the air and making many days feel hot and sunny. Some days the heat can even make the air feel heavy, and big puffy clouds might form, bringing a quick summer rainstorm. But after the rain, the sun comes back out and everything feels fresh and bright again. Hey, have you ever noticed that the sun stays out much longer in the summer? That's because summer has the longest days of the year. The sun rises early in the morning and sets later in the evening than in other seasons. This means more time to play and have fun. And summer is fun, right? It's such a blast! Some families take trips to the beach, the mountains, or even amusement parks, but you don't have to travel far to have a great summer. Playing outside, splashing in a pool, or having a picnic in the backyard can make summer feel extra special. Now, people aren't the only ones who love this season. Plants love it too. They enjoy all the extra sunshine that summer brings. In the spring, trees and flowers start to grow, and in the summer, they get even bigger and stronger. The plants soak up the sunshine and get plenty of rain to help them grow. It's an amazing time of year to be a plant. Now, if we're going to talk about summer, we have to talk about the incredible food that ripens and becomes ready to eat this time of year. Three of my favorites are strawberries, tomatoes, and watermelons. I have to be honest, I'm a huge strawberry fan. I love tomatoes, especially on a sandwich, and watermelon is amazing! If I'm packing a picnic, you better believe watermelon will be present, all right? These delicious fruits are not only super tasty, but also healthy. Strawberries are sweet and full of vitamins, tomatoes are packed with nutrients, and watermelons are so refreshing and hydrating on a hot day. When I think of summer, I don't just think about what happens during the day. There's something I absolutely love about summer nights. The night comes alive with sound. Have you ever listened to the sounds of a summer night? You can hear crickets chirping, frogs croaking, cicadas buzzing, and more. These creatures love the warm weather and use their sounds to talk to each other. If you go outside on a summer night, you can hear so many sounds, it's like they're playing a concert for you. Wow. On top of that, depending on where you live, you might even see fireflies, also known as lightning bugs, twinkling in the night. So you can hear a concert and see a light show at the same time. How awesome is that? Summer is such a fun season full of sunshine, warm days, exciting adventures, right? But just like all seasons, it doesn't last forever. As the days go by, things start to change. The air feels a little cooler, the days get shorter, and the leaves on the trees start to turn beautiful colors. That's when we know it's the next season of the year, fall. Wow, fall! Fall usually begins around September 22nd or 23rd, and lasts until December 21st or 22nd. Wait, stop this fall music immediately, okay? Stop the music. That can't be right, can it? Fall lasts until December 21st or 22nd? Well, yeah, it does. Fall goes on longer than most people think. Even though the weather starts to cool down and the leaves start to change early in the season, fall doesn't officially end until December 21st or 22nd. Fall usually begins around September 22nd or 23rd and lasts until December 21st or 22nd. Here's something interesting. Some people call this season autumn instead of fall. Autumn comes from an old word that means the season of harvest. Fall is used as the season's name because, well, the leaves fall from the trees. I'm going to use the word fall throughout this video, but just know it can also be called autumn. Now, fall is a season of changing temperatures. It's the time between the heat of summer and the cold of winter. The beginning of fall can still feel warm, but as the days go by, the air turns crisp and cool. The mornings and evenings can get especially chilly. Then, toward the end of fall, it can feel really cold, like winter. As the temperatures begin to drop in fall, something amazing starts to happen to most of the trees. The leaves of the trees change color. Yeah, they change color. As the days get shorter and cooler, the green leaves on many trees turn red, orange, and yellow. Then these colorful leaves dry up and fall to the ground. That's why we call the season fall, right? And when the leaves fall, they get all over the place, don't they? Leaves cover yards, sidewalks, and parks, and they can crunch when you walk on them. They can make a crunching sound like when someone eats carrots. Yummy carrots. Hey, speaking of carrots, fall is a season of harvest. A season of harvest. That means fall is the time of year when many crops are ready to be picked and enjoyed. Apples, pumpkins, and other types of squash are some of the most popular foods of the season. Many people visit farms to pick apples or choose the perfect pumpkin for carving. They can be used to make delicious seasonal treats like apple cider and pumpkin pie. Fall is a season of change. Cooler temperatures, colorful leaves, and delicious harvest foods make it a special time of year. The days grow shorter, the last leaves fall, and the air turns even colder until we come to the next season, winter. Yeah, winter. Winter usually begins around December 21st or 22nd and lasts until March 19th or 20th. That means most of the season takes place in the first months of a new year. Winter usually begins around December 21st or 22nd and lasts until March 19th or 20th. When people think of winter, the first thing that usually comes to mind is the cold, and it can be very cold. Winter is the coldest season of the year. The temperatures drop, and in many places, the air feels icy and crisp. You might need to bundle up in warm coats, hats, and gloves just to step outside. In some areas, snow falls from the sky, covering the ground like a fluffy white blanket. You might remember from my other videos, I live in South Carolina. The area in South Carolina where I live doesn't usually get snow, but the year I'm making this video, a nice snowstorm came to my area. It was magical. It really was. I was like, wow, hello, snow. I appreciate you stopping by. It was super cool. Winter is also known for having the shortest days of the year. This means that during winter, the sun rises later in the morning and sets earlier in the evening. It can feel like the days fly by quickly because it's dark out much earlier than it is during the other seasons. With the colder temperatures and shorter days, the world outside starts to look a lot different, especially the trees. In winter, many of the trees have bare branches. That's because many trees go into a resting state, almost like they're asleep. Without leaves, they don't need as much energy. They're just waiting for warmer weather to return. Okay, well, what about animals? How do different animals survive the chilly winter months? Well, some animals, like bears and groundhogs, hibernate during the winter, which means they sleep for weeks or even months to save energy. Other animals, like squirrels and deer, stay active but have to work harder to find food. Here's a little squirrel that found some food. That's great. I hope you find a lot today, okay? A little hard-working squirrel. Oh, I guess he had to go. Then some animals, like certain birds and butterflies, escape the cold by flying to warmer places until spring arrives. That's called migration. Migration. They know it's going to get cold and they're like, hey, let's get out of here. We'll come back when it's warm again. And you know what? That makes sense. That's smart. Hey, what about people? Well, people have different ways of enjoying the winter season. If you live in a place that gets snow, you can enjoy sledding and building snowmen. Just make sure you bundle up. With the weather being colder, many people spend time on indoor activities like reading books, playing games, or crafting. Whether it's the thrill of outdoor adventures or the comfort of being indoors, winter has something cool to offer everyone. Well, those are the four seasons of the year. After winter, we have spring, and it all begins again. Each season is special in its own way, bringing different weather, changes in nature, and fun things to do. No matter what time of year it is, there's always something amazing to see and enjoy. That was a blast. You're like a Seasons of the Year expert now. I appreciate you learning with me. You did a tremendous job. If you want more cool learning videos and you haven't yet, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out. I want to give a huge thank you to my patrons for making these lessons possible. You all are the best. And to everyone watching, you're awesome. Keep up the great work. And you know what? I'll see you next time.